this clean energy revolution is the greatest blue-collar job creation engine in generations in the United States of America, and we're going to fight here in this building and on Capitol Hill to make sure that this revolution continues to be protected, because the planet is warming. There are no emergency rooms for our planets. We have to engage in massive preventative health care for this planet.
It is so great to be here at the 20th, soon to be 30th, get-together for an expo that I think bears such relevance for all of us, because it's about certainly stewardship of our environment. It's certainly about innovation in our economy. It's certainly about our national security, and it is certainly about our economic growth as a nation. So hooray, hooray to each and every one in here.
And environmental resources in southeastern Pennsylvania, our farmland, historic parks, and watersheds are extremely important to myself, having grown up there and still living there, as well as my constituents. And they play a critical role in our economy and the quality of life in our communities.
To truly stand up for science, we must work together to defend science-based laws from attack.
And we want to work with utilities to help really reform the regulatory regime and create a level playing field, a better marketplace for these technologies. So we can help mayors have more resilient, reliable, efficient, clean energy sources right in their backyard.
The U.S. imports 5 million barrels of oil each day, and transportation accounts for 70% of that. At the Wilton E. Scott Institute for Energy Innovation, we believe in adopting electrical vehicles.
Today we're highlighting our acre study and showing how our enzyme technology and microtechnology can be applied on 1 acre of cropland.